Hello everyone, this is the first lecture on the topics from the first module of the second semester complementary mathematics coming under the Calcutta University syllabus. In this lecture, we will be discussing the concept of polar coordinates and the relation connecting Cartesian and polar coordinates. Consider a point xy in Cartesian plane. So let this be the point x, y. This P be the point with Cartesian coordinates x and y. So we know in Cartesian coordinates, if this is the point xy, we have this length is x and this length is y. Now the Cartesian representation of the same point P is nothing but r, theta, where r is actually the distance or length of this line segment. So this is r and theta is nothing but this angle between this positive x-axis and this line. So the point xy can also be represented in polar coordinates as r, theta, where r is this length and theta is the angle between the positive x-axis and this line segment. Now to find the relation connecting this Cartesian coordinates x, y and the polar coordinates r, theta. Consider this triangle. We have this is a right angle triangle. So from this rectangle we have this is y and this is x, right? So from this rectangle we have cos theta equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. We have the adjacent side is x, adjacent side of this theta is x and hypotenuse is r. So this is x by r. So from this we get x equal to r cos theta, x equal to r cos theta. Also from this triangle we have sine theta equal to, we have sine theta equal to opposite side divided by hypotenuse. So opposite side of this angle is y divided by hypotenuse is r. So this is nothing but y by r. So sin theta equal to y by r. So we have y equal to r sin theta. So this is the relation connecting xy and r theta. That is the a point in Cartesian coordinates and polar coordinates. So if you are given a Cartesian coordinate r, theta, we can convert this to a polar coordinate x, y by using this relation. Now how to find r and theta? We know from this we have x square plus y square is equal to, from these two equations we have x square plus y square is equal to r square cos square theta plus r square sin square theta. This is nothing but r square into cos square theta plus sin square theta equal to 1. So x square plus y square equal to r square. That implies we have r is equal to square root of x square plus y square. So if we are given a Cartesian coordinates x and y, we will get the polar coordinates r theta, and r is obtained by using this relation. And to get theta, we can use, once we obtain r, we can use this relation for getting theta, because we have cos theta equal to x by r. So if you obtain the value of r, we can use that relation or this relation. Otherwise you can use from these two equations x equal to r cos theta, since x equal to r cos theta y equal to r sin theta implies y by x is equal to r sin theta divided by r cos theta. That means dividing this r, we have tan theta is equal to y by x. So from this relation we will obtain the value, or we will obtain the theta, the angle theta. That is that theta equal to tan inverse of y by x. Theta equal to tan inverse of y by x. So once we obtain the value of x and y, that is if we have the value, the Cartesian coordinates, we can convert this into polar coordinates by using these two formulae. Now if you are talking about the angle, we know this is actually theta equal to 0. This is theta equal to 0. This line is theta equal to 0. This is theta equal to pi by 2. This is theta equal to 2 pi by 2, that is pi. And this is equal to theta equal to 3 pi by 2. Actually, we know the relation between radian measure and the degree measure. Actually, these measures are in radian, that is 0 radian, pi by 2 radian, pi radian and 3 pi by 2 radian. We have the relation connecting radian measure and degree measure is actually we have pi radian is equal to 180 degree. Pi radian is equal to 180 degree. So we have one, therefore we have 1 radian is equal to 180 by pi degree, or we have 1 degree is equal to pi by 180 radian. So we know this relation connecting radian measure and degree measure. So actually this is theta equal to 0 degree or 0 radian, but this is theta equal to pi by 2 radian, that means it is 90 degree. This is theta equal to pi radian or 180 degree. This is 3 pi by 2 radian or 270 degree. And this is actually we can say that this is theta equal to 0 or theta equal to 2 pi. This is actually 360 degree. In radian it is 2 pi radian or 0 radian. And in degree it is 360 degree or 0 degree. So we have the angle pi by 2 or pi by 4 or 45 degree. It will be like this. This will be pi by 4 radian and this will be pi by 2 radian. This will be 3 pi by 4 radian. We have this is 3 pi by 4 radian. This is 2 pi by 4, that is pi by 2. This is pi by 2 and this is pi. Then this is actually 3 pi by 2, etc. So usually we will take the values of r as positive, but we can consider the negative values for r also. For example, suppose this point is r comma theta. So we know the length of this is actually r and theta will be this angle. So if you are considering the point minus r theta, before entering to that, we can check what is mean by this r equal to a constant a. R equal to a constant a means that r equal to a
and theta can take any value. That means
theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. We know theta is actually varies from 0 to 2 pi. Okay, so r equal to a means that theta varies from 0 to 2 pi. So actually it will be this. So that is we have a circle with radius a r equal to a and center at 0, because theta varies from 0 to 2 pi and r equal to a here. So r equal to a means as a circle with the center 0 and radius a, because we have from this circle c at any point we know the length of this the radius will be r equal to a here, right? So this is actually r equal to a means that it is a circle if you are taking r is only positive values. Okay, now what about theta equal to a constant b? Theta equal to a constant b. We know theta equal to constant b means that r can take any value. If you are considering only positive values for r, so r can take any value from 0 to infinity, right? So theta equal to b means that we have a radial line at the angle theta equal to b. So it will be like this. Okay. So if this is the angle B, then theta equal to B means that this radial line, right? If R is negative, we can take that this will be this line. If you are considering the negative values for all R also, then we have theta equal to b means this line. Okay, this line will be that is a line passing through this point 0, 0 at the angle theta equal to b. Okay, if you are considering only the positive values for R, we have this theta equal to b means this radial line only. This radial line only, right? And this means that R can take any value. R can take any value. If we are restricting R here, we will get a point. Suppose theta equal to b and R equal to some 2, then we have a point like here. This will be, this length is 2 and this is b. Okay, again here also, if you are R equal to a means that if you are restricting a theta equal to some point here, some constant here, that is, if you are considering theta equal to some pi by 4 here along with R equal to a, so we have the point a comma pi by 4. That means if you are restricting theta as pi by 4, we have this angle is pi by 4. So this length is a and this angle is pi by 4. So this will take this point a comma pi by 4. Okay, so R equal to a constant means that it is a circle with a radius that constant and center at 0. And theta equal to a constant, the angle equal to a constant means that we will get a radial line at an angle theta equal to b if R is greater than 0. If you are considering negative values also, we will get this line, right, at an angle b. So if you are considering the point r comma theta here, we have this length is r and this angle is theta. So if we need to plot the negative r comma theta, if you are considering the negative values of r also, then negative r comma theta is actually r theta means one moves at a distance r positively, right, like this. That is, one moves along this line. That is, this line means theta equal to some point theta or theta naught. So r comma theta naught, or r, this is r naught comma theta naught. If we are considering this, so this line length will be r naught and this angle will be theta equal to theta naught. So r naught comma theta naught means that one moves positively along this line at a distance of r naught. Right, one moving along this line at a distance of r naught. So negative r naught comma theta naught means that this actually theta naught is this line. So negative r naught means one moving along this line negatively at a distance r naught. Okay, so this is negative r naught actually. Actually, we are considering this point as minus r naught comma theta naught. That means if this is theta naught, and this is actually theta naught, so we are taking the negative of r naught, so we will get this point. Okay, the same point also can be written as taking r as positive. So r naught comma, we have, if you are taking this is in positive sense, if this is r naught, then we have this will be, what will be this? This is theta naught, this is theta naught, so this angle will be theta naught plus some pi, right? So this is actually r comma r naught plus theta naught plus pi. So the same point, if this point is r naught comma theta naught, this point can be represented by using negative r naught and r naught. So if you are representing by negative r naught, it will be negative r naught comma theta naught. That is, the angle will be same. That is, if this angle theta naught with r naught, we have this point. So if you are negativing the r naught, so we will get this point. Okay, and the same point can also be written as r naught comma theta plus pi, or theta naught plus pi. So what about this point r naught comma minus theta naught? If we have this r naught comma, this point is r naught comma theta naught, then r naught comma minus theta naught is actually, we have, this is theta naught, so minus theta naught is actually this in the negative direction, and r naught will be the in positive direction. So this will be the point. This is actually negative theta naught. If this is theta naught, we have this is negative theta naught. This angle is also, we can express this is 2 pi by 2 pi minus theta naught, right? So this is actually r naught comma negative theta naught. So correspondingly, we will have this point. This point is actually negative r naught comma negative theta naught. Clear? Or if you are taking the positive values for r naught, we can express this point also by r naught comma. This angle is theta naught plus pi by 2. That is theta naught plus pi by 2. So this same point can also be expressed in this coordinates also. Okay, that's all for now. We can discuss some examples in the next lecture. Thank you.